Manush, this year did you pass in this school?
1988.
You passed in 1988. What did you do after that? I mean, now you are teaching mathematics in
yes.
school, right?
Hmm.
Senior section.
From classes 7 to 10.
Okay.
7 to 10.
So, what did you do immediately after passing in school?
After passing, I went to Calcutta, St. Xaviers, got enrolled in plus 2.
Mm-hmm.
Class 11 actually. But I stayed for only 6 to 7 months. 89 February I returned, came back to Sahibganj. Then I finished my plus 2 from Sahibganj College. Did graduation from here only, physics honours. And while after finishing, as usual, I started giving private tuition to students in order to support my family. Then 97 September I joined school. And that first year I was teaching classes 4 and 5. Slowly I was given more responsibility, and with the passing of time, this year I got class 10. Last year 9 and this year class 10. So more responsibility being put on my shoulder with the passing of time.
Well, who were some of your classmates in the school that you can think of right now?
Hillol Sarkar, Subhajit Kaur, Nihanshu, Sheel, Shekhar, Ajay Khudania, Kuntal Hussain.
Okay. Are you still in touch with Kuntal, are these boys?
No, not in touch, but I get some news. Kuntal is a doctor, as
mm-hmm.
I heard.
Mm-hmm.
Hillol, I think he did his engineering, but about placement and all that, no idea. Subhajit Kaur, he is, I think, in Calcutta, maybe MBA or something, not very sure. I mean, here and there I get some, not direct link as such. Snihanshu is a doctor in Mumbai, as Shekhar told me.
Manush, you were a student, now you are a teacher. How was St. Xaviers then and how is St. Xaviers now? You have seen both sides of it.
I find lack in the sense of belonging, what we felt those days.
Among students?
Among the students and also the teachers, I mean, that giving, so they don't give as much as we got. And the students also, that still, as you mentioned in your speech, or I think about school, as you said, Sunday, if I don't come, I feel something is missing, that kind of thing.
There's a little Hindi word, if I may use it, lagao.
Ha, ha,
ha. That's not there.
Ha, ha, that is not there. So,
what do you think is the reason behind it?
That is, I will say, changing situation, that means they are coming studying, they think that we are paying money, okay, getting what, then going off. Not so much attached, but our days we didn't think in terms of that money and this and that. So more, that means I am taking tuition from this teacher, then I know him, I wish him, others I don't know much. That kind of feeling has.
Manush, you have elder sister, Moshumi was a teacher in school.
Yes.
Your younger sister didn't teach you?
No, she did not teach.
So all three of you, one brother and two sisters, studied in the same school.
Yes.
And Manush, as a student, I'm sure you must have had many joyous occasions. Can you cite one or two happy moments which you can recollect right now as a student? You studied from KG1?
KG1 to class 10, almost 12 years.
I know it's difficult to suddenly recollect
assemble,
something.
Assemble, assemble.
Anything that
yes,
comes
yes.
to your mind right
assemble.
Now. Not in that order maybe, but anyway.
When, I will not say something individual but collective, mostly during the concert when the Bengali drama or some Bengali program used to get appreciation, so I used to feel very joyful.
Okay.
That
so when you are taking part in it.
Even if I am not a part of it, but
okay.
as such,
oh, right.
so we don't find that thing here, no Bengali representation now.
Now, as a teacher, what has been some of your very happy moments? Now you have been seeing your students passing from the schools and doing well in life. You have been teaching the last 12 years or so.
Yes, more
so
than
what has been your
years.
Most noticeable achievement?
Still, some students, they meet me, ex-students who have passed out. So, they still say that, sir, we cannot forget you. And we still miss your teaching wherever we go, we miss your teaching and we cannot forget. But when I ask them that, what is it that you can describe? The sir, we cannot say that in words.
Certain things
but,
cannot
but
kind of
we still miss you.
Yeah, I mean, before you say something, just tell you one thing. We interviewed a few of your students and some they had to speak very highly of you. I think one of your students said that her love for mathematics grew because of you. That's a great compliment. You can be an ideal teacher for many. And Manash, what do you have to say to your friends who have been working in various parts of the country and even abroad? Maybe you're not in touch with each other, but once they get to see you on the website, they would love to hear from you.
Means if possible, come and visit us.
Okay.
Remember the school, remember us.
So Manush, do you have any contact details and how can they contact you over the phone? Or
just phone, I have taken a mobile phone last 2 months back. I can give my mobile number as well as landline.
Can you give the mobile number?
Mobile number, yes.
You can just say it.
963-184-28-91.
So since he is a mathematician, he speaks in that way.
3322.
Okay.
So 6 plus 2 plus 3 is 10. Same kit number, how to remember.
Did you have a hard time choosing your mobile phone number?
No. One of my colleagues, he helped me to, because he is...
Manush and his mobile number reminds me of John Nash.
And I'm in the process of helping my son to memorize it. He knows the landline number.
Okay.
But sometimes he makes mistake in the last 2 digits.
Okay.
So after he gets fully used to it, I will push through this one, this 10 digits.
Now your son is also studying in the school, right?
Yes.
So he's a second generation. Okay. So you teach him.
Yes, I try to teach mostly the parallel things. Means you read, you pronounce this one, or let's say some words, for example, crow, crow, then add a word, d, it becomes crowd.
Okay.
Because main
thing, I should add something. We discovered something in Manush's house this morning when he went to visit his father and mother. And in the bedroom, we saw a blackboard and where he had written down the tables of four, so that when his child gets up in the morning, the first thing he sees is the table.
No, it is written
and on
by
the left hand
him
side,
only.
It is written by the child himself.
Yes, yes.
And on the left hand side, there is a Bengali alphabet. That's how Manush teaches his son. So unique and so creative.
Manush, the Bengali alphabet has been given to him by his grandfather.
Okay.
Because he also happened to be a primary school teacher.
So you are a family of teachers, actually.
That way.
And now that you are a teacher and have been teaching for the last 12 years, so what would you like to tell your students who have passed from the school? Some message for them? They would love to hear from you.
Work hard and be honest.
Very
only two words.
That's a beautiful thing to say. Work hard and be honest.
Be honest.
So,
and that
Manush, there was something that we realized and I have been telling everybody. Your students, school administration, your classmates, your seniors, that's me, your parents, your relatives, your sisters and your in-laws, they speak so highly of you. So I would say you are a typical example of what St. Xavier's product, for whom the school can rightly be proud, and you could be a very good idol, not just for your students but also for us. Thank you very much, Manush. It's wonderful talking to you.
It's all blessings of seniors.